in the hands of our God. Our lives are opened up for the glory of the Lord to radiate from our hearts, from our lives. There is much that is closed up in our life because we don't dare open up. In the past, when we opened our lives up to God and to others, perhaps we met with resistance and indifference. We loved and we felt rejected by those we loved. We trusted people and we felt betrayed. We counted on people and they turned away from us. We thought someone would stand by us, but they found reasons not to have anything to do with us. We helped people generously. These same people, at the moment of our need, did not even care to come to us. As a result of these negative experiences of our past, we closed our hearts against others and even against God. We want the Holy Spirit to move. The Holy Spirit to move into the corners of our heart that are closed. We even thought that God did not care. We questioned the very existence and the relevance of God for our life. We were getting more and more closed up on ourselves, on our sorrows, on our sadness, on our anger and hatred, and we became lonely. The pain of loneliness added with the pain of incomprehension. The pain of incomprehension because we did not understand. We did not understand why everything is going wrong. Is there a meaning for life at all? We questioned. At this moment, let us ask the Holy Spirit to move. Move into our hearts in a very gentle way, opening us to God and to each other, so that as God wants us to be, let us be radiant and beautiful in the world around us. Let's keep our hands open in front. Let's keep our hearts open for the movement of the Spirit. And let us sing together, Spirit move, waiting for the Holy Spirit to be poured into our hearts, into our sorrows, into our anxieties, into our troubles and trials. Let the Holy Spirit be poured. Let us feel the movement the movement of the Spirit. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My dear sisters and brothers, there is a flower that is named after the sun. It's called sunflower. In the dark, you can't even see it. It is irrelevant. It is closed up. All the petals are closed upon each other. There's nothing beautiful, nothing magnificent about that bud. But when the sun rises in the east, the flower opens up. The petals begin to open up, and in no time, it is radiant and magnificent, a big, yellow, radiating beauty. And it always turns to the sun. It follows the movement of the sun. As long as it is turned to the sun, it is available for all of us. Its beauty and radiance is opened for all of us to see and rejoice in its beautiful presence, the sunflower. My dear sisters and brothers, our hearts are created for God. As St. Augustine centuries ago declared, "For you, O God, our hearts are created." Our hearts will be opened up only in the presence of God, where God is not felt. Our hearts remain closed up, dried up, closed upon its sorrows, its troubles, its sadness, its complaints, its narrowness. But the moment the sun rises upon it, the moment God is perceived, our hearts begin to move. Our hearts begin to move, opening itself up to God and to everyone around us. Today, we are waiting for such an experience in our lives. Why are we sad? Why are we hurt? Why do we dwell on our hurts? Why do we close ourselves up from others? Why does the wife not talk to the husband? Why is the husband running to the court of divorce? Why is the young man, the son, turning away from the father and the mother? Why is there conflict in our offices and places of work? Why are we sick? Why do we languish in the sorrow and complaints? The only reason is our hearts are not opened to the sun. I'm a flower, you're a flower, all of us are flowers, to be opened up and become radiant beauties. But then we remain closed up and irrelevant because there's darkness around us. Today, the Lord is coming to our hearts to make His presence felt, and that's when we will be opened up. My dear friends, it's a beautiful story, an event in the Bible, Luke chapter 19, the story of Zacchaeus, a very powerful character in the Gospels. This man who ran to see Jesus. At one moment, only Jesus was real for him. He did not care what the other people would say. He did not care about his own position and prestige. He was the chief tax collector of the district Jericho, and that means he was the most powerful Roman official in Jericho. And he was guarded by Roman soldiers. And he was a man of authority. Anything would happen at the note of this man, Zacchaeus. And yet, when the sun of Jesus began to shine on him, he did not care for his name and fame, for his guards, Roman guards, for his prestige. He ran, we are told. Only Jesus was real. And he climbed up on a sycamore tree, and there he was sitting. And Jesus came. The sun rose in the horizon of his life. Jesus smiled, and he was flabbergasted. Jesus called him by name, and Zacchaeus came running down, we are told, hurried down from the tree, and Jesus went to his house and declared salvation. Everything was different with his life from that moment. The story that I am going to tell you is what happened after that. It is not in the Gospels, no. It is my own story. Every now and then, Zacchaeus would be found missing. And nobody knew where he went. And Mrs. Zacchaeus, the wife, began to be a little suspicious. Where is he going? And she asked him, "You go early morning, all dressed up, and you come back late in the evening? When you go, you would be a little sad and irritable, but when you come back, you're all joy, all smiles on your face. Where are you going?" And Zacchaeus would just dismiss that query. And the wife was suspicious. What's happening to the husband in his old age? Any woman entering his life or something? Somebody exploiting him? And the wife called their eldest son and said to him, "Son, there's a problem with the dad. Don't know what. He's going, disappearing early morning with the makeup all dressed up and comes back all happy. I ask him, he doesn't tell me where he's going. If he's going to a good place, why doesn't he tell me? And if he doesn't tell me where he's going, that means he's going to a wrong place. All that happiness he comes back with cannot be from a right source. My son, you follow him, follow the dad. Next time when dad dresses up, I will tell you, follow him at a distance and see where he's going. We need to help our dad." And the son agreed. A couple of weeks after, when the lady saw the husband dressing up, she called her son and told him, "Son, This is the time, follow him. At a distance, the son followed. What the son saw was strange. Zacchaeus was walking early morning. At one time he began to run. Where was he running to? The son was noting he was running to a tree. And as soon as he reached that tree, he hugged that tree and began to cry his heart out. And then he climbed up the tree and he sat perched on a branch and he began to sing and laugh and cry and come down and run around the tree, hug the tree once again, climb up the tree again, come back the whole day, loving the tree, around the tree. And before the dad was coming away from the tree, the son came and told the mother, "Mom, bad news. Things are worse than you anticipated. Dad is gone nuts. This is what he's doing. The whole day, hugging the tree, kissing the tree, climbing up the tree, and he looked like crazy. What is he doing all this for?" Then Zacchaeus came back, all in smiles. The wife confronted him, "Tell me, why do you do this?" And Zacchaeus hugged her and with a smile said to her, "Darling, that tree is very special in my life. It is sitting on that tree that I saw my God, the face of my Lord Jesus. And perched on that branch of that tree, I heard my God calling me by name, Zacchaeus, inviting me into his presence, into his heart. And then he said to me, 'Let's go home. Remember, I came with our Master, Jesus. All the blessedness that you and I experience in our family is from that moment. Till that, I was a cruel man. We were guarded by Roman soldiers, and therefore the poor people did not attack us, not because they respected us, but because they were afraid of the Roman soldiers. But remember the people coming and crying because I, together with my henchmen, went and took all their money by cruel means. All that I wanted was money. I was greedy. I was a man of lust. I could not love you. I could not love our children. I was all closed up. I was all closed up on my own sorrows, my own loneliness. I wanted to cover up my sorrows, my loneliness, my nothingness by amassing more and more wealth. The more I gathered, the less did that wealth make me happy. The less it made me happy, the more empty and void I felt. And I gathered more and more through cruel ways. But that day, sitting on top of that tree, I saw my Jesus smiling at me, loving me, calling me by name. And that's when I understood the real beauty of life. I am opened up from that moment. If there is joy in my heart, if there is love in my life, it is only what I receive from my Jesus, from my Lord. And whenever I feel a little sad, whenever I feel tempted, whenever I feel sorrowful and empty, I go to that tree for that same experience of being opened up. I do not want to close up my life anymore. I don't want my life to be closed up on my own sorrows and loneliness, on my own hatred and anger. I want always to be open, to be opened in the ray of the sun, in the love of my Master. And that's why I go there. And when I come back, you understand why I'm so happy. And they praised God together. Hallelujah.